Electric field. The area around a charged body where another charge experiences a force is called electric field. For example, we have taken a positive charge here and its field is represented by this circle. Within this circle, in this particular area, other charges will experience a force due to the electric field of this positive charge. Electric field intensity. The magnitude of force per unit positive test charge placed at that point is called electric field intensity. For example, a test charge is placed here near the field of this positive charge, and this positive charge is applying force on this test charge. So the force applied by this positive charge on this test charge is called electric field intensity. And formula of electric field intensity is E is equals to F upon Q naught. Here F is force applied by this positive charge on this test charge, and Q naught is magnitude of this test charge. SI unit of electric field intensity is Newton per Coulomb or volt per meter. Electric field intensity due to point charge. Here we have placed a source charge Q and a test charge Q naught at a distance r from the source charge Q. In order to find out the field intensity due to point charge Q naught, it is placed at a distance r from a source charge Q. As we have discussed Coulomb's law, by Coulomb's law, the force experienced by a point charge Q naught due to field of a source charge Q, F is equals to K Q Q naught divided by R square. Here K is Coulomb's constant, Q is magnitude of the source charge, and Q naught is magnitude of the test charge, and R is the distance between source charge and test charge. As R cap is the unit vector directed from Q to Q naught, therefore in vector form Coulomb's force can be written as F is equals to K Q Q naught divided by R square into unit vector R cap. So the field intensity due to point charge is given by E is equals to F upon Q naught. By putting the value of F from equation number A into equation number B, we get equation number C. Q naught is cancelled by Q naught and we get E is equals to K Q divided by R square into unit vector R cap. The strength of field is proportional to the magnitude of source charge Q. Greater the magnitude of source charge, greater will be its strength of field. Electric field lines. Electric field lines are an excellent way of visualizing electric fields. They were first introduced by Michael Faraday himself. The electric field in the vicinity of a charged body can be expressed by imaginary lines called electric field lines. So basically, electric field lines are imaginary lines. A field line is drawn tangential to the net at a point. Thus, at any point, tangent to the electric field line matches the direction of the electric field at that point. In figure A, a positive source charge is given and its electric field lines are outward as shown in figure by the help of arrows. Electric field lines always initiate from a positive charge and terminates at a negative charge. In figure B, a negative charge is given and its electric field lines are inward. Direction of electric field lines of a negative charge is always inward. Electric field lines are continuous lines whose direction is everywhere that of the electric field. Electric field lines point in the direction of the electric field, start at positive charges or at infinity, end at negative charges or at infinity. Electric field lines are more dense where the field has greater magnitude. Here in figure B, magnitude of source charge is doubled as compared to figure A. So we can see that in figure B, field lines are more dense. In figure A, field lines are initiating from the positive charge and terminating at negative charge. And by drawing a tangent, we can find the net field at that point. In figure B, magnitude of positive charge is twice of the magnitude of negative charge. Field lines are initiating from plus 2q charge and terminating at minus q charge. Electric field lines of plus 2q charge are more dense due to the greater magnitude of the positive charge. In figure C, we have two similar positive charges and both are initiating the electric field lines outward from them. Include the properties of electric field lines. These lines are imaginary lines. The relative density of field lines around a point corresponds to relative strength of the electric field at that point. The field lines never intersect each other because these lines are perpendicular to the point. The magnitude of charge and the number of field lines both are proportional to each other. The start point of the field lines is at the positive charge and end at the negative charge. For the field lines to either start or end at infinity, a single charge must be used. Question: what will be field lines due to positive charge placed near metal plate? In this figure, you can see that a positive charge is placed near a metal plate. This positive charge will attract the negative charges in this metal plate, and negative charges will come at the surface of metal plate. As we know that electric field lines initiate from the positive charge and terminate at the negative charge, and from this positive charge, electric field lines will be initiated and it will terminate at negative charge, which will be on the surface of the metal plate. So these electric field lines will be perpendicular to this metal plate surface. Electric flux. Let's suppose we have a source charge and it has many electric field lines, and few of them are passing through the area of this plane. Only those electric field lines which are passing through the area of this plane are known as electric flux. And it is defined as the number of lines of forces that pass through the area placed in the electric field, or the scalar product of electric field E and vector area A is called electric flux. We define vector area as an area whose magnitude is equal to the surface area and direction is normal to the surface area is called vector area. Because we are taking area as a vector quantity, so we have defined its direction normal to its surface area. Electric flux is defined by phi and it is equals to E dot A, and we get phi is equals to E A cos theta. The electric flux depends upon the orientation of surface area with respect to the field lines. Electric flux at an angle. Remember that we have taken vector area and vector area is normal to the surface of plane. When the area is making an angle with the electric field lines, the electric flux can be determined by phi is equals to E A cos theta. The number of lines passing through the area will depend upon angle theta. If the surface is perpendicular to the field such that surface area is parallel to the electric field, then maximum electric lines of forces will pass through the surface. Because angle between electric field lines and vector area A is theta is equals to 0, By putting theta is equals to 0, we get phi is equals to EA cos 0. Because cos 0 is equals to 1, we get phi is equals to EA. Therefore, large number of lines passes through the area. 0 or minimum electric flux. If the surface is parallel to the field such that surface area is perpendicular to the electric field, then no electric lines of force will pass through the surface, as the angle between electric field lines and vector area is 90 degree. We put theta is equals to 90 degree and we get phi is equals to EA cos 90 degree. Cos 90 degree is equals to 0, and then we get phi is equals to 0. Therefore, no lines passes through the area. We have a question here. Calculate the flux passing through a surface whose vector area is 2 meter square. The total electric field lines passing parallel through that area is 5 Newton per Coulomb. As electric field is E is equals to 5 Newton per Coulomb, vector area is equals to 2 meter square, and angle between electric field lines and vector area is equals to theta is equals to 0 degree. Because electric field lines are parallel to the vector area, so we have theta is equals to 0. We know that electric flux is equals to E dot del A, and which is equals to E del A cos theta. By putting values of E, A and theta, we get phi is equals to 10 Newton meter square per Coulomb or 10 Webers. Students, now try to solve this question by yourself. Two charges are separated by a distance r and have a force of interaction F on each other, which is F is equals to kq1q2 divided by r square. Now find the force of interaction between these charges when the distance between these charges is doubled, and find the force of interaction between these charges if the q1 is doubled. Magnitude of q1 charge is doubled. And find the force of interaction between these charges if q1 and q2 both are doubled and distance between them r is half. Answers are also shown here for your help. So try to solve these questions as soon as possible. Now solve this question. Identify the direction of electric field at point P in the following cases. In figure A, 4 Coulomb charge is given, and find out the direction of electric field due to this 4 Coulomb charge at point P. In figure B, again 4 Coulomb charge is given. Find the direction of electric field due to this 4 Coulomb charge at point P. In figure C, minus 4 Coulomb charge is given, and find the direction of electric field at point P due to this minus 4 Coulomb charge. In figure D, minus 4 Coulomb charge is given, and find the direction of this minus 4 Coulomb charge at point P. This is numerical number 1 of exercise. What is the magnitude of the force of attraction between an iron nucleus bearing Q is equals to 26E and its innermost electron if the distance between them is 1 exponent minus 12 meter? Charge on nucleus is given, which is Q1 is equals to 26E. Here E is 1.6 exponent minus 19 coulombs. By multiplying it with 26, we get Q1 is equals to 41.6 exponent minus 19 coulombs. We know that charge on electron is Q2 is equals to 1.6 exponent minus 19 coulombs. The distance between them is R is equals to 1 exponent minus 12 meters. Coulomb's constant is equals to K is equals to 9 exponent 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. We also know the value of Coulomb's constant, and we have to find the force of attraction between q1 and q2. Using Coulomb's law, F is equal to K Q1 Q2 upon R square. Putting the values in equation number 1, and after calculation we get F is equal to 6 exponent minus 3 newtons.